I'm Gail Locke McDowell, author of Cracking the Coding Interview. In this video, I'm going to cover trees. A tree is best thought of in this sort of picture. You have a root node at the very top, and it has child nodes. And each of those child nodes, they have child nodes themselves, and so on and so on. Very often when we're talking about trees, we talk about binary trees. A binary tree means that each node has no more than two child nodes. That is, that each node has a left node and a right node. Of course, one or both of those could also be null. Very often when we're talking about binary trees, we actually want to talk about binary search trees. A binary search tree is a binary tree which fulfills a specific ordering property. So on any subtree, the left nodes are less than the root node, which is less than all of the right nodes. This ordering property makes finding a node very, very fast because we have a pretty good idea of where it would be. So suppose we're looking for 17 in this tree. We can say, okay, is 17 bigger or smaller than the root node? Well, it's bigger than the root node, so let's go to the right. Now, is it bigger or smaller than that next node there? Well, it's smaller than that node, so it must be on the left of it. And so very, very quickly, we can start to zoom in on where that node will be. Because at each operation, we've chopped off, hopefully, about half of the nodes. And we do that over and over again, and very, very quickly we find the node we're looking for. So it makes finds very, very fast. But how do those elements get in there in the first place? Well, let's talk about how inserts work. Inserts work much like finding an element works. We start with some element we want to insert, like say 19, and we say, is it bigger or smaller than the root? Well, it's bigger, so let's go to the right. Now, is it bigger or smaller than that next node? It's smaller, so let's go to the left. And we do this over and over again until we get to an empty spot or a null node. And then we say, okay, that's where we should insert our new element. Now, the one problem here is that if we get elements in a particular order, we could get really imbalanced. Suppose we have a new binary search tree and we just follow the properties of insertion. So we insert 1 and then 2 to its right and then 3 to its right and 4 to its right. We're going to get this data structure that looks less like a tree and more like a long list. And then inserts and finds will no longer be so fast. There are some algorithms that can ensure that our tree stays balanced. That is, that roughly the same number of nodes will be on the left side of the subtree and on the right. These algorithms get pretty complicated, so we're not going to go into the details here. But it's worth knowing that they're built into a lot of programming languages. And in a lot of cases in interview questions, you'll just assume that you have a balanced tree. The last operation to talk about is traversing, or walking through a tree. So there's three common ways we walk through a tree. We can do an in-order traversal, a pre-order traversal, or a post-order traversal. A pre-order traversal means that you visit the root first, and then you visit its left nodes and its right nodes. In an in-order traversal, you visit the left nodes first, then the current node, and then you go to the right nodes. In a post-order traversal, the root node comes up last. So you visit the left nodes, then the right nodes, then the current root node. Typically in binary search trees, we want to do in-order traversals because that actually allows the nodes to be printed in order. So for example, on this tree here, it was just a 1, a 2, and a 3. The nodes in an in-order traversal will actually be printed out in the order 1, then 2, then 3. So typically we'll see in-order traversals. Now that we've covered the basic operations, let's take a look at the code for a binary search tree. To implement a binary search tree, we'll need a class node that has pointers to the left node and the right node, and then some sort of data, presumably. And I'm going to give ourselves a constructor just to make our lives a little bit easier. Okay. So the first method I'm going to add is an insert method. And this is going to take in, I'm going to call it value here. This is going to take in a node, or take in a node value, and look to the left and the right to see where we want to insert it. So first, if value is less than or equal to the actual data of our node, then we should insert it on the left side. If there is no left node yet, then this becomes my new node. Otherwise, then I ask my left to insert it, and I push that down the recursion stack. And then otherwise, if value is bigger than data, than myself, then it should be inserted on the right side. And so if there is no right node, put this as my right node. Otherwise, ask my right to insert it. Okay, so that's the basics of insert. Okay, so let's walk through this code on an example. So we have the simple tree, and we want to insert the value 8. So we call 10.insert of 8, and 8 is smaller than 10. So we go to the left, and we call left.insert of 8, so 5.insert of 8. 8 is bigger than 5, so we go, and we don't have a right child, and so we set 5's right child equal to 8. The next method I'll do is find. So find is going to operate recursively, just like insert. In fact, it'll be somewhat similar in a lot of ways. And it's going to want to return a Boolean. And actually, I'm going to call this contains because we're not really finding the node so much as checking if the tree contains it. Okay, so first of all, if I'm there, return true. Otherwise, if value is smaller than data, then it should be on the left side. If there is no left node, then I know the answer is false. Otherwise, if there is a left node, go ask my left node what the answer is. Okay, now I do the same thing on the right. I can just do an else. If right is null, if there is no right node, then the answer is false. Otherwise, go ask my right child and return its answer. All right, so that's the recursive implementation of contains. So let's walk through this function, imagining we're trying to find the value 8 that we had just inserted. So we call 10.contains of 8. 8 is smaller than 10, so go to the left. And then we do 5.contains of 8. 5 is smaller than 8, and so we go to the right. And then, of course, we see that 8 in fact equals 8, and so we return true all the way up the stack. The final method that I'll implement is a in-order traversal. Specifically, I'm going to print all of the nodes in the tree. So I just call this print in order, and this is actually very simple. First, if I have a left child, then I do my in-order printing first of my left child. Then I print my own data. And then, same thing on the right. If right is not null, then I do right.printInOrder. So remember that in-order traversals do the left child, myself, and then my right child. So that's exactly what the code here does. So that's how we do an in-order printing. Let's walk through what this code does. So we're going to first call 10.printInOrder. 10 is going to say left.printInOrder first. That's the very first thing that's going to happen. Then we're going to print the root, and then it's going to say right.printInOrder. So we're going to recurse down, and 5, so we can get 5.printInOrder. 5 is going to say, okay, print, we've got nothing on the left to print, so print me next. And then call right.printInOrder where 8 will get printed. And then we're going to go back up to 10, and 10 is going to get printed. And then we're going to go and go down to the right in that third step and print 15. So that's how an in-order traversal works. If we want to do a pre or post-order traversal, we do a very, very similar thing, just in a slightly different order. A pre-order traversal means that the root gets printed first. So we'd print the root, then print the left subtree, then print the right. In a post-order traversal, the root gets printed last. So we'd print the left, then print the right, and then we print the root node. So it's a pretty natural translation of the algorithmic concepts. A lot of times in interviews, people get kind of intimidated by the idea of implementing a binary search tree. They just assume it's something really challenging. But if you understand the concept pretty well, you can just take that and just translate it fairly directly into the code. Just be really careful about the null pointer checks. So now that we've gone through the basic operations, why don't you try out these concepts on a new problem? Good luck.